Now, next fiber which we are going to discuss is nylon. So, we are going to discuss now about nylon. Now, nylon, the word, the spelling, it is nylon. So, why this nylon? Does this word has got any reason or any meaning? So, this word is taken from the two words. Now, I will be talking first of all why it is taken. This nylon was made at two places simultaneously. One is New York. It was made at New York as well as in London. Now, that is the reason the name is taken from the two words over here, that is NY and lawn of London. And in this way the name comes nylon. So nylon is the synthetic fiber. I can say now this one is the first synthetic fiber. It is first synthetic fiber. So nylon is the first synthetic fiber. And this word nylon means what? It is made of two words, NY, which has been taken from the word New York, NY, and LON is for London. Why it is done so? Because it was made at two places simultaneously, and that is New York and London. That is the reason the word nylon has been taken. Now, as I said, this is the first synthetic material, first synthetic fiber, and basically this is a polyamide. Now, when I say that the nylon is polyamide, that means it is made up of artificial polyamide. If I talk about only polyamide, this word, so if we talk about this word, so even wool and silk are the natural polyamides, isn't it? Silk and wool are natural polyamide. But this one is the artificial one, and it is made by using coal, air and even water. That means the petroleum product, it is made by using coal. So this is a synthetic polyamide, and this was the first fabric which was made totally artificially. Here natural things are not utilized. Now natural thing means I'm talking about natural cellulose. Now what is the next to talk about nylon? Now we will talk about certain properties of nylon. So how what are the properties of nylon? As I told before also that at the end of the chapter we are going to discuss certain very common properties of synthetic material, all the synthetic material, but as now we have to discuss about the properties of nylon. So nylon basically is very light material. It is very light material, light in the sense it is not too heavy, light, but it is very strong also. Now when I use this word strong, so it has got highest tensile strength. Now what is the meaning of this and how can we prove this? To prove this, if an experiment is done, just take the thread of the nylon, take wool and also take the thread of cotton. Now try to add weight on this. We have to break this thread. So you will find you will have to keep on adding weights to break this. First of all, you start with cotton. Now when we have to break the cotton, you will add certain weight on this so that it can be broken. Then you will do with wool and wool, and then you will do with nylon. You will be surprised to know that you will need more weights in case of nylon. That means you will have to put more, you will have to add weight, more weight to break the nylon. That means the strength, the if we talk about the power, the strength of the material, tensile strength of the material, then nylon has got the highest tensile strength. Then it can be followed, or it is followed by wool, and the least strength if we talk about it is of cotton. So that is the reason I have written over here that this one is light, it one is, this one is strong. Now nylon do not absorb water, do not absorb water. Now when this do not absorb water means it dries also faster because it will be absorbing very less amount of water, so it will be dried, can be dried or dry easily. To do this, see, to prove the tensile strength, we did a small experiment that we took the three kinds of thread, nylon thread, wool, and then again along with this we have taken the thread of cotton also, and we kept on adding the weights, and we just observed that which thread needs more weight to be to divide, to break them. So I told that here nylon needs more weight, or it will be little difficult to break nylon, more weight has to be added. So the one which will be broken first will be cotton, then wool, and the third one will be nylon. In the same way, when I say that it do not absorb water and it dries easily or dry easily, so even to prove this you can take the example, you can do this also. Take two mugs or two cups and add or take equal amount of water in that, and then take the cotton fabric, cotton material, a hanky or whatever, a piece of equal length of two pieces, of one of what, one of cotton and the other one of nylon. You put the both the cloth in the separate mug, and then remove it out, remove extra water from the cloth, and you will find that cotton absorbs more, cotton absorbs more water. And then the second thing which has to be noticed is put both this cloth to dry, hang it somewhere. Now you will find which will be the one which will remain wet for longer time, or which will dry up faster. So you will find that nylon gets become dry faster, it dries up faster. Why? Because the amount of water which is absorbed is less, and so definitely it is when the amount of water inside is less, and so it is going to dry faster. So till now what we have read, that nylon is the first metal which is totally synthetic. It is made by using coal, air and water. It is a natural polyamide, and when we talk about polyamide, the silk and the wool are the natural polyamides. And then if we know that it was made simultaneously in New York and London, and so the words are being taken from this New York and London, and so it is known as nylon. If we talk about the properties, this